I hope all of you are good and safe at home. So today once again we will start our topic linear equation in one variable. So already in our previous class I have explained exercise 2.1 some questions. So 3 and 4 questions are left. So we will start these questions once again. So exercise 1.1 question number 1. 7x minus 9 is equal to 16. 7x minus 9 is equal to 16. So first I am telling you again about the linear equation in one variable. So what is linear equation in one variable? This equation is written on the board. You can see all of you. So this is linear equation in one variable. Why? Because here how many variables you are using? You can see only one variable. This is x. What is the variable? X. X you are using. One variable, and what is the power of x? So power of x is 1. What is the power of x? It is 1. It means this is linear equation in one variable. Okay, so this is called linear equation. Okay, because power of the x, power of the variable should be equal to 1 is called the linear equation. So how will you solve this type of equation? So I have already told you in your previous class also. So beta, I am telling once again, when where variable is given, so you will put the variable one side and other values another side. Okay. So 16, 9 you can take right hand side, so it will be coming division because it is given left hand side in minus. Okay, so when you are taking right hand side, so it will be coming addition. Now you have to add the number. So 7x is equal to 25. Now x, what will be the value of x? So simply you can say x7 is given in multiplication of x, so it is coming division. So you can say x is equal to 25 upon 7. Okay, and you can verify your answer when you will put at the place of x 25 upon 7. So it will be 7 and 7 you can cancel out. So what is left? 25, and 25 minus 9, so it will be 16. Okay. So how will you solve the linear equation in one variable? Simply you have to put the variable one side and other values one side. Okay. And when you are putting the other values one side, it means sign will change. When you are taking minus 9 right hand side, so it will come in division. And 7 even in multiplication left hand side, when you are taking right hand side, so it will come in division. So 25 upon 7. Clear? Next question. Question number 10, 14y minus 8 is equal to 13. Okay, 14y minus 8 is equal to 13. So how will you solve the equation? So simply variables one side, so 14y is given in variable, 13 and 8 you will take right hand side, so it will be that. Okay. Now 14y is equal to 13 plus 8, you will get the answer 21. Now what will be the value of y? So 21 divided by 14. And you can cancel out both the numerator and denominator by 7. So 7 is a 21 and 7 is a 14. So what will be the value of y? It will be 3 by 2. Okay, what is the value of y? You can say 3 by 2. Okay, simple beta, simple equation, how can you solve? If any equation is given, so what will you have to do? First step, variable one side and all the values another side. Okay. So 14y you will put as it is left hand side, equal to condition as it is right hand side, 13 is already given, 8 you have to take right hand side. So it is given in subtraction, so it will be add. So 13 plus 8, 21. Now you can see 14, okay. With the variable 14 is also given. So you will take 14 right hand side again. Okay, because you have to find the value of y, not 14y. Okay, so 14 when you will take right hand side, so it will come in division again. So 21 upon 14, so you can cancel out by 7, 7, 3 and 21, 7 is a 14. So what will be the answer? 3 by 2. Clear? Next question. Question number 11. 17 plus 6p is equal to 9. So you can say first, in this equation where is the variable? So variable is given on left hand side of the equation. So variable you will put one side only, this is left hand side, and all the other values on other side. So right hand side already 9 is given, so you will put as it is. Now 17 you have to take right hand side, so it will come in subtraction. Okay? Now 60 as it is, 9 minus 17 you will get minus 8. And what will be the value of P? Minus 8, 6 is in multiplication left hand side, so you will take right hand side, so it will come in division. Now you can cancel out by 2, 2 4 is 8, 8 is 6, so minus 4 by 3. So value of P will be minus 4 by 3. Clear?
What is the value of P? So you can say minus 4 by 3. Next.
Question number 12. X by 3 is equal to 1 plus 7 upon 15. X upon 3 is equal to 1 plus 7 upon 15. This is also the linear equation. One variable, power is 1. Okay, so how will you solve? So simple. Left hand side, you will put the variable value. So it will be as it is. Right hand side, already the numbers are given. So in denominator, nothing is given. You can take 1. You will take the LCM of the number, 15 and 1. So it will be 15. Now 15 divided by 1, 15. And multiply by 1, so it will be 15 only. 15 divided by 15, 1 you will multiply by 7, so it will be 7. X upon 3 is equal to 22 by 15. Okay, now you have to find the value of X. It means what is the value with X? It is given, you will take another side. So X divided by 3. So you will take 22 by 15 as it is. 3 is given in division left hand side, so you will take right hand side and it will come in multiplication. Now you can cancel out, 3 ones are 3, 3 fives are 15. So 22 by 5. So value of X will be 22 upon 5. This will be your answer.
So in first exercise you have to do only the, you have to solve the linear equation in
one variable. Okay, so how will you solve? So first, all the equations are given, left hand side variable, one side variable is given, another side number is given. So first step you have to do, you will put all the variables values one side and another values another side. And after that you have to find the value of the variable. Clear?
Now beta, we will, first exercise done. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can ask in your doubt class. And now we will start our second exercise.
So second exercise, it is based on application. Okay, based on some application. Okay, so statement type exercise given, right, totally based on the applications. So what is the applications here you are using? For example, what will be the perimeter of rectangle, area of rectangle, how will you find out? Next, what is the area of square and what is the perimeter of square? Like that, based on the application, questions are given.
Vishadi, apne bete ko dekho, kabhi na nikala.
Theek hai. Okay, so all the questions are based on the application. Okay, so what is the perimeter of rectangle? What is area of rectangle? I am telling, how will you find out the area of rectangle?
For example, you have a rectangle A, B, C, D. Okay, this one is length, this one is breadth. This one is length, this one is breadth. Clear? Now, you can say what will be the perimeter of rectangle. Perimeter means perimeter of rectangle. How will you find out the perimeter of rectangle? Sum of all the sides. Sum of all sides. Perimeter means sum of all the sides. So what are the sides here? L, P, L, B. It means length is given 2 times and breadth is given 2 times. It means L plus B plus B. It means 2L plus 2B. And what will be, you can take common 2, so it will be L plus B. Okay, so L plus B means L is you are using for length, B you are using for breadth. So what will be the parameter? 2 into length plus breadth. Next, what is the area of rectangle?
ओके सो इफ यू हैव फाउंड द एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल सो व्हाट विल बी द एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल सो सिंपली यू कैन से इट विल बी लेंथ मल्टीप्लाई ब्रेथ ओके एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल हाउ विल यू फाइंड आउट द एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल यू कैन से एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल विल बी इक्वल टू लेंथ मल्टीप्लाई ब्रेथ एंड इन शॉर्ट फॉर्म यू कैन राइट एल इंटू बी ओके सो फॉर फाइंडिंग द एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल यू विल यूज द फॉर्मूला लेंथ इंटू ब्रेथ सो पेरिमीटर मीन्स सम ऑफ ऑल द साइड्स सो लेंथ यू आर गिविंग यूजिंग टू टाइम्स ओके अपोजिट साइड्स इट विल बी लेंथ एंड अनदर अपोजिट साइड इट विल बी ब्रेथ सो हाउ विल यू फाइंड आउट द पेरिमीटर सम ऑफ ऑल द साइड्स इट विल बी टू इंटू लेंथ प्लस Clear? So based on some application, second exercise is given. So we will start our second exercise one by one. We will see the questions. So question number one. What is question number one? Open your books. In question number one, it is given. If you subtract,
subtract 1 by 2 from a number
if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result
and multiply the result by 1 by 2
and multiply the result by 1 by 2 you get 1 by 8
you get 1 by 8 so what is the number so what is the number
so what is the question simple you can say if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply
the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. So, what is the number? So, what will be the solution of the question? So, simple, you can say you don't have any number. So, first you will assume that the number is equal to x. First, you will let the number. The number is x. Now, if you subtract 1 by 2, okay, now you will go according to question. According to question, what is given? You subtract 1 by 2 from a number. 1 by 2 subtract karte ho kisme se? From a number. So, x minus 1 by 2. You are subtracting 1 by 2 from a number, and what is the number? Number you have assumed that is x. So, x minus 1 by 2. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2. Okay. So, you are getting this result after subtraction 1 by 2 from x. And you are multiplying this result by 1 by 2. Clear? So, you get 1 by 8. So, aapko kya answer milta hai? 1 by 8. So, you have to find the number. So, here you have got one equation. You will solve this equation and find out the number. So, beta, what is the condition? I am telling you once again. First, you have to find the number in this question. So, you have to assume that number is equal to x. Now, what is the condition? If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number. So, you are subtracting 1 by 2 from a number. And number is x. It means x minus 1 by 2. And multiply the result by 1 by 2. और जो भी रिजल्ट आया सब्ट्रैक्ट करने के बाद उसको क्या करना है 1 by 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करना है सो x माइनस 1 by 2 यू विल मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1 by 2 सो यू आर गेटिंग द रिजल्ट 1 by 8 सो फाइंड आउट द नंबर नाउ वी विल सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन सो 1 by 2 मल्टीप्लाई x माइनस 1 by 2 इज इक्वल टू 1 by 8 ओके सो हियर यू कैन सी ओके 1 by 2 इट मींस यू विल मल्टीप्लाई आउटसाइड द ब्रैकेट इट इज गिवन 1 by 2 इनसाइड टू नंबर्स आर गिवन इन सब्ट्रैक्शन इट मींस हियर व्हाट प्रॉपर्टी यू विल यूज Distributive property, you will multiply 1 by 2 by x also and 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 also. So, open the bracket.
So you will get 1 by 2 into x. And here what is the minus? As it is, 1 by 2 multiply 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 8. Clear? Next, multiply then. So 1 by 2 multiply x, it means x by 2 minus 1 by 2 multiply 1 by 2. So you will get 1 by 4 and is equal to 1 by 8. Clear? Now you have seen here linear equation is coming again. Okay. So already you have solved this type of equation. So you can solve easily. X by 2 you will put one side. 1 by 8 already given right hand side. 1 by 4 when you are taking right hand side. So it will come in addition. Clear? Now you will take the LCM of the 8 and 4. Okay. What will you do? You will take the LCM. So what will be the LCM of 8 and 2? So x by 2 as it is, and LCM of 8 and 4 will be 8. It will be 1 plus 2. So it will be 3 by 8. Clear? You are getting 3 by 8. Clear? Now what is given? X upon 2 is equal to 3 upon 8. Okay, x upon 2 is equal to 3 upon 8. Now then you have to find the value of x. So it means it is given with x division, in division it is given 2. That also you have to take right hand side. So it is given in division. So what will you do? If you are taking it into right hand side, so it will come in multiplication. So simple, x will be equal to 3 upon 8 multiply 2. And you can cancel out 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So what will be the value of x? You can say 3 by 4. Clear? What will be the value of x? You can say 3 by 4. So what will be that number? So what is the number? So you can say hence the number, equal to 3 by 4. Clear? Hence the number will be equal to 3 by 4. What are you getting the result here? Simple. You can say 3 by 4. So what will be the answer? You can say the number will be 3 by 4. Clear? X is equal to 3 by 4. If it is not visible, beta, you can write here. Okay. Hence, the number will be equal to 3 by 4. Okay. Now I am explaining once again what are you doing in this question, beta. So simple, what is given? If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. So what will be the number? Okay. So simple, beta, in this question, first you have to assume, because you don't have any number, first you have to find out the number. Okay. So for finding any number, you have to assume the number that like the number is equal to x. Now, according to the question, according to the condition, what is given? You subtract 1 by 2 from a number. It means you are subtracting 1 by 2 from a number and number is x. So it means x minus 1 by 2 and multiply the result by 1 by 2. So this result means x minus 1 by 2 you will multiply by 1 by 2. So you are getting the answer 1 by 8. It means equal to 1 by 8. Okay. Now you have to solve this equation. So how will you solve this equation? This is distributive type property. So how will you solve? First you will multiply 1 by 2 by x. After that 1 by 2 you will multiply by 1 by 2. Clear? So 1 by 2 multiply x minus 1 by 2 multiply 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 8. Clear? So beta, here how will you multiply? Simple, numerator you will multiply with numerator and denominator with denominator. So 1 multiply x, here you will get x by 2 minus 1 upon 4 is equal to 1 by 8. Now again you have got one linear equation. So linear equation how will you solve? Simply, I have already told you, variable you will put one side and all the other values another side. So x by 2 as it is equal to 1 by 8 and 1 by 4 you will take right hand side. Now, you can see right hand side is given 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4. So, how will you solve 1 by 8 and 1 by 4? Two fractions are given, addition, subtraction. So, how will you solve? Taking LCM. Okay. So, you will take the LCM here. So, what is the LCM of 8 and 4? So, simply you can say it will be 8. And when you are taking LCM, so you will get the answer 3 by 8. So, right hand side, what is left? X by 2. And right hand side is 3 upon 8. Okay. Now, left hand side it is given x by 2, but you have to find the value of x. So what will you do? This 2 you will take right hand side, and when you are taking right hand side, so it will come. come in multiplication. So 3 by 8 multiply 2 and you can cancel out 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. So you will get the answer 3 by 4. So here you are getting x is equal to 3 by 4. So what you have assumed the x, x is the number. Okay. So in the last you can write hence the number will be equal to